Alrighty guys, well we're down in the final six. This is your host ID Jester. Top 17 card and dice review. Six remaining. Which is the lucky number six? Well, let's find out and take a look. And that's right, this one's going to be Status Pro Baseball. So Status Pro Baseball was actually game number 12 for me last time I did this review. And and there's a reason why it was I rated it that low last time. And the why it's down to number six this time. And the reasons is going to be when we talk under the game weakness. I'll go into more details than that. So first Status Pro Advance for you guys information you're going to roll. Let's take a look at a card here. So you're going to look at a roll. Oh, let's look at the pitcher first. You're going to roll on the pitcher card, and if it falls within their pitcher rating, then the second dice roll will come off of their card. If it comes outside their rating, like Matt Whistler, it would be 2-6. So you roll two six-sided dice to get a number between 2 and 12. If it falls between 2 and 6, then it's going to come off of his card, and it's a 2d8 to get the actual out result or hit result. You can see 11 to 88 are the results there. These cards have got the lefty-righty splits, which we'll talk about in a little bit. So if it comes off the batter card, same thing. So that's basically it. You're going to check and see if the pitcher controls it. If he doesn't control it, it comes off of the batter card. Is there a computer version? Actually, yes, there is a computer version. If you go to statusprobaseballonline.com, there's actually a Status Pro Baseball game, although I would... You know, try it out if it's something you might like. I had some issues with it. I was trying to set up a game between San Francisco and Texas, which are the two teams you get from 2010. And the issues I ran into was a starting pitcher for the World Series for Texas wasn't even carded for the Texas team. And then the starting catcher, which happened to be Benji Molina, was actually on the San Francisco Giants team and then gets traded to Texas later in the season. So he had a San Francisco card, but no Texas card. So I couldn't even set up like game one of the World Series and those other two teams they give you. So I would think you'd be able to. So anyways, I think it's not real good shape. I think it was in beta for a while, and I don't know how much support has gone into this, but you know, you can give it a try if you're interested. Status Pro Baseball Online. Is there a way to order printed cards? Yes. Order PDFs? Yes. Okay. Game strengths, pitcher adjustments. So you know that number we saw 2-6, you can actually get that number increased or lowered before the game. You can roll every time a pitcher comes in and it might adjust it up or down, which I think is a great option because there's nothing, you know, if you're facing a tough pitcher because, you know, the game had coded, you know, he's a tough pitcher, Clayton Kershaw or Max Scherzer or whoever, right? He could have an off day. They all do, right? So some of the times they might get lower stats as opposed to higher stats. So I like the pitcher adjustment. You can play with fast action cards or dice, or you can have a nice combination between the two of them. If you haven't seen Status Pro Advanced, you can check out Bleacher Bums Gaming. He does quite a few Status Pro games on his channel. And he does a really nice job, uses the dice, and then uses the fast action cards to get the out results. It's a really good combination. But, of course, you could use just fast action cards. You could use just dice. I think the gameplay and the flow of the game is really quick. It's really smooth. There's not a lot of... nonsense rolls or rolls where you are wasted rolls, I guess, which is nice. And of course, the super good modding support, which we'll talk about in a minute. Game weaknesses, error checks. This is another one of these games that has the error check. If you use dice, you got to remember. The fast action cards will have an asterisk on results to remind you to check for errors. If you just use the dice, you got to remember. And certain results that come off the batter card, then you got to check for an error. So the error checks, again, I think could have been implemented a little bit better, easier. But, you know, it is what it is. If you order cards online, we're going to actually, let's talk about it now, I guess. So there is, all right, how do we talk about this? So there was Status Bro, and it was really good for a long time, and then it kind of went defunct, went out of business, and the company stopped producing it. And after the company started stopped producing it, I guess the license went into limbo or something. I'm not sure. I'm not an expert. I'm not an attorney. I'm not a lawyer. This is just my understanding of what happened. So the license went into limbo. So people started creating their own user season files and everything for the game system, because the game system actually showed, you know, basically how to create the cards. If this player has this rating, then he should have this. And, you know, so people were creating their own season files. Well, then these people started selling the season files because the license went defunct or something like that, I guess. Eventually, the owner or somebody picked back up the license, but because it went defunct, they had to change the licensing into Status Pro Advanced. So you can find out information about Status Pro if you go to the Facebook page and do a search for Status Pro Advanced, I think is what it's called. That's where the actual continuation of the Status Pro is. But there are a lot of people out there that sell their own version of the Status Pro and have their own, you know, sites and links to their files and everything. You can find them on the Delphi forums or on eBay and stuff like that. And they'll sell you like these offshoot files like this one here. And they will, you know, they'll sell you their season files. So if you purchase some of these offshoots from other people, then each person has like their own card design, uses sometimes their own rating systems. Some of them, you know, have different charts they use because there's different versions of the charts. So you can run into issues with the card design, and that's probably why I gave this game a 12 as opposed to a 6 like I did this time, is because of all of those issues you can run into. You won't run into those issues if you stick with, Status Pro Advanced. You stick with the licensee of it, and you order your cards from that one person. You won't have those issues, but you will run into issues if you do download some of the user-supported mods out there, or, you know, purchase them from other people that are selling their season files as well. Lefty-righty splits. The game was not designed originally to have lefty-righty splits. And so a lot of people don't even include lefty-righty splits anymore in their season files. I think the Status Pro Advance has gone back and redone a bunch of the previous seasons so that they do have lefty-righty splits. So if that is important to you, you should check and make sure there is lefty-righty splits if the season file you want to purchase before you purchase it. And then, of course, you can have some issues with the cards and the charts. Like I said, some people use version 1 of the charts, which doesn't incorporate like the catcher throw rating. And then there was the original charts, which I think had like, if I'm not mistaken, it was like an OBR rating of 0, 1, or 2. And then they switched that in version 2 or 3 of the rules. And then it was like an OBR of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. So it depends on which version of the, you know, cards, which version they're using to create their files. You need to make sure you're using the proper charts. It can be a little bit confusing, but let's talk about all of the qualities of this game. Value, you usually get a really good value, and 6 is probably pretty low. I didn't want to give it too high a score. It's probably, to be honest, like a 7 and 8. The season files that I've ordered are really good, you know, value. They're not very expensive when you order the PDFs. I think I ordered like 3 season files. They were like $10 a piece. I think I got them for $8 because I ordered like 3 of them. So I got like 3 season files for like $24. Quality, I don't personally have the printed cards from Status Pro Advance, but I did see a good friend of the channel, Bleacher Bums Gaming. He's got some really good Status Pro Advanced cards on his channel. The cards look really good. He's talked really positive about them. So instead of just giving it a 5, I will give it a 6 because I have seen the quality. I don't haven't experienced it yet. It's probably, again, one of those that should be a 7 or 8, but I don't want to give it a 7 or 8 until I actually have the cards in my hand. I am hoping to order a season file here when things settle down with coronavirus. Support from the company, mods, etc. The support for Status Pro Advance is out of this world. It's great. And then, of course, you have free seasons on the internet that you can go and download. There's different websites that host the old season files and stuff. You can see here, I got the 1955 season here that I downloaded for free from one of the websites. It comes with everything, but again, no lefty-righty splits or anything because that's not the way the game was originally created. This, you know, was, you know, 1955 season, so I can get this for free, print it out, and download it, and I have it for free. You can do that for yourself. There's probably a good 10 to 15 different seasons that from different websites that you can download for free. Availability of seasons, extra players, etc., I think are really good. The Status Pro Advance has quite a few seasons available. Most of the seasons come with a ton of players. I think I saw on his website or his Facebook page, the 2019 season had over like 1,500 player carded. If you order the printed set, I think it comes with over 1,500 cards. So that's going to be, you know, quite a good value. And it's going to have a lot of those extra fringe players as well. Ease and flow of the game, again, super good. Flow is really excellent. It's just dice roll. It's either going to come on the pitcher or the batter. And, you know, if you don't get a hit result, it's going to be an out. You can flip up the fast action card or you can roll on a dice chart to see what the out is and move on to the next guy. There's no wasted time looking up a lot of extra information or rolling on a chart to go to another chart. There's none of that stuff in this game. So the flow is really good. You know, it's not a super easy game, but it's not super complex either. It's one of those nice designs. It's actually designed really, really well, and that's why it's been around so long and why it's so popular. If you don't own Status Pro Advanced Baseball, if you don't own Status Pro Baseball at all, I recommend that you at least download a couple of those season files for free and go to the Facebook page and check out the Status Pro Advanced. Join up on his Facebook channel. And then he's got an order form there, an email address and everything where you can, I think the PDFs are like $12.50, and then depending on which season you want, it tells you when it was last updated because again, some of the rules have changed in the last couple years. So depending on which version of the rules you want, if you want the lefty-righty splits or whatever, you'll have to, you know, contact the person and find out what is going to be the best option for you there. If you just want to find out more about the game and haven't played it, hadn't tried it out, I would definitely recommend you just download some of the free seasons that people host out there on different baseball sim channels and stuff like that. And that will at least let you download it and play it for free and give it a try and let you see if it's something you might want to actually purchase some seasons on. I highly recommend this game. Like I said, if you don't own it at all, the worst thing is you should be doing is downloading the free seasons and trying it out, because it is a really good game. It flows really well. And like I said, it only gets better with the more lefty-righty splits are built into the system, the more advanced rules and stuff. This is a game I think is came out in the 60s, so obviously it has that kind of older design to it, and so they've been incorporating new things since the rebirth, I guess, of Status Pro Baseball. So it's one of these games that I can say you won't be disappointed, I think. And if you don't want to invest anything right off the bat, you can find a few season files. Again, probably without the lefty-righty splits, but you know, pretty free on the internet. Or you can get a couple of the you know, the PDFs for a pretty reasonable price. So that is game number 6. What's left is just the top 5, and we'll be done with our 2020 review. So thanks for joining me. We'll see you all next time.